Welcome back to What's Trending. Hi, guys.
Hi, Maya. Hi, Maya.
You know, the weekend just ended. The long weekend, sadly. But it was Halloween. Did you guys do anything?
No.
Boring.
No, we're past that already, I think.
Legit story. I was browsing through the Instagram stories of my friends. Okay. They were out in costumes. I got tired.
You got tired?
I got tired just watching them.
Look,
I'm a legit tito.
When my brother went out and then he says, I'm going out, I literally just got home to sleep. So it was that type of day for me.
So it was just like a normal day for you guys.
Yep.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, you know, a lot of our PBA players, you know, they came out to, you know, to party.
Yeah.
To dress up as their, I don't know, I mean, their favorite characters.
Yeah.
So let's look into that, okay? So the PBA Halloween. First up, we have June Marfajardo as the Joker.
Man, you know,
this was crazy. It was crazy. You know, first, he did put on his own makeup. Second, that boomerang is everything.
Yep.
You know, again, he's a man of many talents. And I think that June Mar doing that, it just goes to show off his fun side. That
I agree.
That whoever's close to him, we all know it exists.
He is the reigning, defending, 5-time PBA MVP, but he also is the winner of this year's Halloween.
Oh, yeah. I agree.
Easy.
Whatever your costume was, you lose June Marfajardo. I legit know that he had shoes that were of the Joker theme. He designed his own Nikes of the Joker theme, but he traded them to Jokic during the World Cup.
Yeah.
He could have, you know, helped if he was wearing Joker shoes with that Joker costume. But who am I to nitpick? June Mar, you win Halloween.
You do, honestly. But, you know, there were other PBA players that came out to dress up as their favorite idols, maybe. And we have here the Phenoms, Kiefer Avena and Eliza Valdez. They went as each other. And this was really funny. I found it very funny. I mean, look at the jersey on Eliza Valdez.
Yes, it's Kiefer's. And
but the pose of Kiefer.
The pose of Kiefer. They really put a thought into every bit of this. I mean, like, now I want to know whether or not Eliza Valdez actually tucks her knees in like that when she's holding the ball. But
yeah, I doubt it.
I want to legit know if those were really her shorts that
he
was wearing.
I mean,
because it was clearly Kiefer's uniform that Eliza was wearing.
Yes, but I don't know
was
about
it the same
Kiefer's
on the other
shorts. Because, yeah. I mean, would that. I mean, are those cycling shorts?
I don't know.
I mean, I don't know. But it was funny.
Yeah.
It was really funny.
No, I enjoyed it, yeah.
And now we also have another PBA player. The Norwoods went as the Jackson 5.
That
this was
nice.
The cutest thing ever.
Yeah.
They really prepared.
Yeah, no, they pulled it off. They made it a big family affair. And, you know, it was just great.
It was. I mean, look at that.
The only way that you can top this if you go as Voltes 5 next year.
Ooh.
Like the entire 5.
Yeah, I hope they're watching this.
We just gave them a good idea.
But, this is amazing. I mean, just to see that.
But wait, and now I'm thinking about if they were the Voltes 5. So does that mean if they come together, they form the robot?
And then just knock it out of the park.
Well, you know, we have a bonus for Halloween.
We do?
We have a bonus.
Okay.
And it wasn't, you know. This is just like a very random thing. Now, Pao, please explain.
No, because my dad has a jersey that he kept, and brother and I always we've used it as Halloween costume. My brother did it this year. This was me like six years ago. Yeah, we'll zoom
it
in there.
That's Paolo.
That's okay, enough
that's
zooming.
Paolo.
That's enough zooming.
So yeah, it was his uniform during the 1988 UAAP season.
And he kept it.
Yeah, and he kept it. He kept it. And you know, a lot of people don't know that that's why Renren Retualo picked number 4.
Really?
And that's why it was retired.
I don't know even Renren knew that he was coming in.
Yeah,
so that's the reason why.
I hope the next time that costume gets resurrected for Halloween, it's for your sister.
You know what? That would be full circle. If she ended up losing it.
You know why Renren picked it? He looked at the list. He saw that he did not make a single 3 in his career.
So
he said, the odds would be in my favor.
Yeah, so I'm going to fill up
that's a low
enough
bar.
Pointers for 2 people. Right? So that's how it worked out.
Okay, so let's move on. Halloween is done. Mm-hmm. Now let's talk about the PBA trades.
Okay.
Now, we have two topics, trades, that we really need to talk about.
Yeah.
So let's first talk about the TNT Katropa and the Blackwater Elite. Now, Bobby Ray Parks Jr. was approved for the for TNT, and he was the second overall pick in 2018. And he is being traded for Don Trolliano and Anthony Semerod and a 2021 first round pick. Now, what are your thoughts on this? How will this affect, you know, the teams that they are going in now?
So, I woke up earlier, went to the gym.
Oh, I'm glad.
Lo and behold, the entire TNT team is there with Mary Parks. People thought I was trying to outscoop them. And really, I did not even know that they were there. But he's already trying to build chemistry with his new teammates. He played alongside some of them, including Troy Rosario in the past. Some of the youngsters as well, RR Pogoy, of course, in those Southeast Asian games. But to me, it should be quite a challenge for Ray Parks, especially if he is given, you know, the liberty to play the point guard position with the TNT Katropa, because they run a very definite system that is centered on the skills, on the brilliance of Jason Castro, who is still one of the very best point guards in the PBA today. And to hand over the keys, as of the moment, to Ray Parks, because Castro is injured,
yes,
it should be very interesting to see how that will come about. But for the Blackwater Elite, it looks like a different team altogether right now.
No, yeah, with the Blackwater Elite, we all know they shipped off a lot of key pieces. And
Alain Maliksi, yeah, Raymar Jose, and Mike Di Gregorio.
And collected a lot of assets in return in terms of picks, in terms of serviceable players. It will be tough for them in the short term. Mm-hmm. But then with all the picks accumulated, you never know. Maybe they'll find a diamond in the rough once again. But then, right now, not necessarily looking too bright for the Blackwater Elite, but let's see whether or not this will pay off in the future.
Yeah, and I'm really looking forward to seeing, you know, the chemistry of all these players and their new teams.
Yeah,
you know,
and, you know, Banchero as well. So Banchero now moving after spending his entire career with the Alaska Aces. You know, with Chris Banchero, you have one of the premier playmakers of the league. You have one of the great offensive weapons. And now in a team with so many point guards, you can actually come up with a starting five of all the point guards.
You know, Chris Banchero so long has been a focal point of everything for the Alaska Aces. He was their leading assist guy in the Commissioner's Cup. But I'm excited as well to see what Rob Herndon can do, because he was not given a lot of opportunities with the Magnolia Hotshots. He was able to play a couple of games here and there. He had his moments, hit a couple of important three-point shots in some of their games. But overall, he did not have a lot of chances to really prove his worth. But with the Alaska Aces, with Coach Jeffrey Carriazo really molding his team into something that he wants, because, you know, he inherited this team with only a couple of weeks to prepare for the Governor's Cup, but now he's pulling off moves left and right because he wants to form a team that he can mold into a champion.
And, you know, Alaska, they're surprising everyone now. So I want to see, you know, how these two players will go up against the other teams now. But thank you so much, you guys. That's it for What's Trending for this week.
Thank you, babe.
That was a fun. This was fun. Talking about all those costumes.
Thank you for having us. And you know what? This is the first time we've actually had fun.
Well, I hope that you guys enjoyed this segment. But stick around, because Shootaround will be right back.